So, good morning everyone. Today we will discuss the concept of event. Event means what? So, event is nothing but it is a condition. So, event means we will give one condition for a particular experiment, that is the random experiment. So, what is the definition of this? The outcome satisfying particular condition, the outcome, whatever outcomes is there which satisfy a particular condition are called the favorable outcomes. Okay. So, the condition, there are many outcomes, but there is a condition. If that condition satisfied, then such outcome is known as the favorable outcome, and the set of favorable outcomes of a given sample space is known as the event. So, for example, see here, example I will take, we will toss one coin, one or two coins, okay. So, two coins we toss, two coins, what will happen? Sample space is, which are the sample space? Already I know, head, tail, and another one is last one, tail. Okay, so these are the sample space. They will give condition. So, condition is what? I will write here condition. Simple example I am taking. Condition is what? Single head should be present. At least one head. Okay, single head means it is nothing but we can take as at least. One head should be present. So, this is the condition. Okay. So, this should be, condition is what? At least one head should be present. So, at least one head means more than one head may be present. Okay. But should be, at least one head should be present. So, this event we will write event A as. So, which are the events? So, events we can write, at least one head means this will not come, because in this outcome there is no head. So, that's why these three will come, that is the head will come, because one head is there here also one head is there, here also one head is there. Okay. So, these are known as the event. Okay. Why it is known as the event? Because it satisfies the given condition. That's why it's known as the event A. Okay. So, see here, the outcome satisfying particular condition are called favorable outcomes. So, these are known as the favorable outcomes. Those are satisfy the given condition. A set of favorable outcomes of a given sample space. So, these are the outcomes. These are known as the favorable outcomes. Why? Because those are satisfy the condition. Okay. And the set of favorable outcomes we will write in the favorable outcomes, we will write in the form of set, that is known as the event. Okay, I hope you understood the concept. Okay, so simple example we will take here. I given, for example, if two coins are tossed, that only I example taken, and A is the event of getting at least one tail. So, this is the condition, at least one tail. Event of getting at least one tail. So, this is the condition. At least one tail is nothing but it is a condition. Then the favorable outcomes are as follows. So, favorable outcomes, at least one tail means it may be more than one tail, but this will not come. This is the, actually it is the sample space. S is equal to, okay. So, sample space will come. Sample space, this is not A, this is the sample space will come. A, S is equal to T, 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 H, H, T, H, H. Why? Because two coins are tossed. So, we want to find out the, what condition is what event you want to find out. So, event we can consider as the A event, and they are given the condition is what? Getting at least one tail. At least one tail means more than one tail may possible. Okay. But not less than one tail. Okay. So, this will not come here. Okay, so this only come what? TT, TH and HT will come. Okay, so this is known as the event. This is known as event, and this is known as the sample space. Sample space doesn't have any condition, and event it is having the condition. Condition is what? Getting at least one day. Okay, I hope you understood. So then the favorable outcomes are as follows. These are known as the favorable outcomes. Why? Because these satisfy the condition. So these are favorable outcomes, and favorable outcomes you will write in the form of set, that is known as the event. Okay, next. Events are generally denoted by capital letters A, B, C, D. So we can take any letter here, that is the I taken the capital A. Okay, so event we denoted by the capital letters A, B, C, D. So next concept we will discuss with the help of small example we will discuss, so you can understand event very easily. See here, two coins are tossed simultaneously. Write the sample space. So we should write the sample space first. Then, and the number of sample points, so sample points is n of s. Also write the following events in the set form. Set form, you have to write the events in the set form. Okay, and write the number of sample points in each event. So you should write the sample points in each event also. First you should write the what? First we should write what sample space. So sample space for two coins, when we toss two coins, what is the sample point, sample space? Already we know head tail, tail head. Okay, so already we discussed with the help of table also, we discussed when we toss the two coins, then sample space become this one. So head, tail, tail, and last one is the tail. Okay, so this becomes the sample space. Okay, now we required what? Number of sample points. So sample points we required. So sample points means nothing but what? Sample points is nothing but n of s. So n of s is how much? 1, 2, 3, 4. So n of s is 4. I hope you understood. Okay, so this is n of s. Now they are given. Also write the following events. So they are given the following events here. So first event, see here, following events in the set form, and write the number of sample points in each event. Okay, so they are given this condition for event A. So condition for event A is what? To get at least one tail. So from this only, please understand, event is the subset of sample space. Subset means sample space. Means what? What is the meaning of this? It is the meaning what? Event always present in sample space. So sample space is for all the events. Okay, all the events. Sample space is the universal set it is. And from that we will select the event. Okay, so why? Because event is the subset. Because event is always present in the sample space. Okay, so from sample space only we have to select the event, that is the event set. To get at least one tail means what? We have to take, we will write the samples, that is the event as A, and we have to take the get at least one tail. At least one tail means, at least means minimum one tail. Minimum one tail should be present. Okay, so minimum one tail means more than one tail may be present. Okay, so you have to write minimum one tail. Head, there is no tail, so it will not come. Head, tail is there, so one tail is there, so we can write head, tail. Minimum one tail, minimum, maximum may be anything, but minimum should be one tail. Okay, so at least, this word is very very important, you should remember, at least means minimum. Okay, minimum one. Okay, so at least one tail. Okay, so that is nothing but one tail should be present. So tail, head, then tail also will come. Why? Because here minimum one tail is there. Maximum how many may be present, but minimum should be one tail. So this is the event A. You should write the what? And write the number of sample points in each event. So number of sample point in each event, so n of A is equal to how much? N of A is how much? Here it is 3. Okay, I hope you understood. A is equal to this one, because condition for event A is what? To get at least one tail. At least one tail means minimum one tail. Minimum on tail means HT, TH and TT. So these are the A. So N of A becomes 3. So second condition we will see. Condition for event B, to get only one head. Only one head. Please understand. Only one head. So in which this sample space you have to check, only one head should be present. Only one head means this one it will come. That is the head, tail is there. So only one head is there. So here it is, only one head is there. So these two conditions or these two elements satisfy this condition. Okay, so that's why event B becomes what? Event B becomes HT and TH. HT, TH. Okay, I hope you are understanding. Only one head. So it should be present, only one head. So this is the B. So N of B becomes what? N of B. They ask what? Number of sample points in each event. So these are the events. B is the event. So in that sample point is how much? Sample point means nothing but element. How many elements are there? This is the one element. This is the another element. So N of for N of B is equal to 2. Next, third we will discuss. Condition for event C, to get at most. At most means it is nothing but, so two words will come, at least. At least means minimum, you should remember. At most means maximum. Okay, so these two words are very very important, you should remember. At most means maximum. Maximum one tail. Maximum one tail means minimum it may be anything, but maximum is one tail, not more than one tail. Okay, it may be no tail also, that is also it will come in the at most condition. Okay, so there may be no tail, no tail, no tail also it will come in this condition only. Okay, but at most means maximum one tail should be present. Maximum one tail, minimum it may be anything. So we can write event C, I hope you are understanding, event C is equal to how much? Maximum maximum one tail. So maximum one tail means it will come, head also will come, minimum it, maximum one tail means minimum may be anything, means if there is no tail also, that is also the element only, that is also the which satisfy the condition. Maximum one tail means minimum may be anything. Okay, so I hope you are understanding. Head also it will come in this condition. Next, head tail, then tail head. Okay, so is it come this tail tail? Because tail is here, the tail tail, how many? Two tails are there, and they told maximum one tail, so two tail will not come. So that's why event C becomes this one. So n of c becomes 3. I hope you are understanding. This is the concept. Last fourth one, condition for event D, to get no head. No head means, so here also head is there, here also head is there, here also head is there. There is no head means only one element is there, that is TT. So we can write event D is equal to what? Tail. Okay, so therefore N of D is equal to how much? Only 1. I hope you understood the concept. Okay, so you should remember this one. At least means minimum, at most means maximum. Okay, so you should remember. So this is the second problem. See here, a bag contains 50 cards. So there is a bag here. In this there are different 50 cards are there. Cards, you know, each card bears only one number from 1 to 50. There are 1 to 50 cards are there. Okay, so in a particular bag, one card is drawn at random from the bag. Please see here, first you should write the sample space. So whatever this they are given, first you should write the sample space. So sample space we will write first. Sample space is nothing but possibility. Sample space is nothing but possibility. So there are 50 cards are there from 1 to 50. When you drawn a simple card, one card is drawn at random. One card is drawn from random means possibility. What you will get the possibility? Possibility that card may be 1, that number card may be 2. The card number may be 3, card number may be 4, up to how much cards are there? There is a 50 cards are there. I hope you are understanding. You are drawn, there are 50 cards in a particular bag. In a particular bag, there are 50 cards and you drawn a single card. One card is drawn at random, anyone. So you can get any number from 1 to 50. That's why this is the possibility. You are telling special sample space is nothing but possibility. So you may get number 1 card, number 2 card, number 3 card, number 4 card, or any number from 1 to 50 card. Okay, I hope you are understood. That's why sample space is from 1 to 50. Write the sample space. This is the sample space. Also write a event A, B and find the number of sample points in them. So here number of samples, sample points in sample space is how much? 50. Okay, so why? Because there is a 50 possibilities. So we will write, this is the first condition we will write. Condition is what? Condition for event A. What they are given? The number on the card is divisible by 6. So divisible by 6 means the card, now condition, you should apply the condition. So number divisible by 6 means, see here, if there is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, if it is like this, up to 50 numbers are there, okay. I am taking example, up to 50 numbers are there. So which number those are divisible by 6? So only 6 is there. Then 12 is there, next number will come, 18 is there, okay, like that, we have to apply the condition now. So, yeah, event A becomes what? Event A becomes divisible by 6 means the number or the card which is divisible by 6. So, you have to select the card which is divisible by 6 number. So, 6 number means 6 it will come, that is the 6. So, table 6 will come, 6, 12, 18, 24. 30, 36, okay, I hope you are understanding, 36, then 42, then 48, 50 will come, no, why, because more than 48 it will come, no, because next number will come, 54, okay, so which is more than 50, so we have to select from sample space only, okay, because event is the subset of, subset of sample space. Okay, event is the subset of sample space. That's why we have to select from sample space only. Sample space starts from 1 to 50. So we have to select from 1 to 50 only. Okay, so this is the event A you got. Then they ask what? See here. Also write the event A, B and find the number of sample points in them. So number of sample points in sample A becomes how much? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So, 8 is the number of samples points in event A. Okay, I hope you understood the concept. Next condition for event B. The number on the card is complete square. Complete square. So, you have to select from 1 to 50 complete square. So, event B, complete square is which one? 1 is also complete square. 4 is also complete square. Okay, I hope you are understanding. 4, then 9, then 16, then 25, then 36, then last one is the 49. Okay, so 49 is also a complete square because 7 into 7, 49, 6 into 6, 36, 5 into 5, 25, 4 into 4, 16. Like that, these are the complete squares. So, N of B is how much? Therefore, N of B is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So, N of B is 7. I hope you understood. This is the problem. Next, we will discuss third problem. A sanitation committee of two members is to be formed from 3 boys and 2 girls. Please understand. We have to form the committee which is having two members committee. And there are how many possibilities are there? 3 boys are there and 2 girls are there. Okay. Write the sample space, yes. So, we have to write the sample space first. So, sample space, we will write first sample space here. To write the sample space, we will consider B1, B2 and B3 are the boys. B1, B2, B3. These are the boys. Okay, we will consider these are the boys. And similarly, G1, G2 are the girls. Two girls are there, G1 and G2. These are the girls. Okay, with the help of this, we will write the sample space. So, sample space, how it will come? You are forming two members committee. Okay, so two members committee means sample space, how it will come? Please understand, sample space S is equal to two member committee. You can select B1, B2, you can select B1, B3. There is no condition here. Okay, condition afterwards will come. So first we will select B1, B2, one committee will form, or two members committee will form, a sanitation committee of two members. It may be B1, B2, two boys are there. So B1, B2 will form first, second will form B1, B3, third may form, okay, B1, B3, then you may form B2, B3, then you may form B3, B1 and B1, B3, here it is same only, because you are selecting the members, you can interchange, B3 you can select first, then B1 you can select afterwards, the condition remains the same only. Here B1, B3 is equal to B3, B1, okay, don't take again here B3, B1, okay, why? Because you are making the committee. You can make the B3 first you can select, and B1 you can select afterwards. The committee will come same only. Okay. Next, B1, G1. Next, B1, G2. Okay, I hope you are understanding. Then B2, G1. Next, B2, G2. Next, B3, G1. Next, B3, G2. Okay, B3, G2. Any other committee it may form? No. Why? Because B1, B2 is over. B1, B3 is over. Next, B2, B3 is also over. So, these three are over. Next, you can select how many are over. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Again, anyone is remaining? G1, G2 also remaining. Please see here. This G1, G2 also remaining, because you can make the G1, G2 girls committee also separately. Okay. So, I hope you understood. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So, N of S becomes 10. Okay. I hope you understood. So, these are the N of S. This is the sample space, and N of S indicates the, write the sample space S and the number of sample points. That is nothing but N of S is 10. Also write the following events in set form and number of sample points in the event. So we will apply the conditions now. So here they are given the N of S. So we will write here separately. So see here. Condition for event A, at least one girl must be a member of the committee. At least one girl matlab, at least means, at least means, see there, at least you have to, at least means minimum. Okay, already I told, at least means minimum one girl should be present there. Maximum it may be anything, but at least one girl. Okay, so we can write here, at least means any one girl should be present. So we can write the event for A. See here there is a girl, no. Here there is a girl, no. Here there is a girl, no. Here there is a girl. So we can write B1 and G1. Similarly, here there is a girl. At least one girl should be present. Okay. It may be more than one girl. Okay. So B1, G2. Similarly, here B2, G1. Similarly, here B2, G2. Then B3, G1. Then B2, B3, G2. I hope you are understanding. This also it will come, because at least means minimum one girl is there. Maximum it may be any two girls also, the minimum at least it may come. At least one girl means minimum one girl. Okay. More than one girl also present. So G1 and G2 also it will come there only. I hope you understood. Okay. So n of a is how much? See here, n of a, that is nothing but number of sample points in the event. So number of sample points in the event, that is you have to make count 1 2 3 4 5 6 7. Okay, so 7 is the n of a. Next condition, see here, condition for event B, committee must be one boy and one girl. Committee must be means there should be one boy and one girl. One boy and one girl we will write as B event, one girl and one boy. You should select from the sample space only. One boy and one girl. Is there any one boy, one girl? This one. Okay. So we can write B1, G1. Similarly, B1, G2. Okay. I hope you are understanding concept. Similarly, B2, G2. Then next, B3, G1. Next, B3, G2, any other, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 5 only over, so B1, G1 is over, B1, G2 is over, B2, G1, so B2, G1 and B2, G2, so B1, B2, G1 I am not taken, so B2, G1. Okay, I hope you are understood. So this is the B event, and n of B is equal to how much? N of B is equal to how much? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So 6 is the n of B. Okay, I hope you understood. Condition for event C. So C event you want to find out. Committee must be means should be of boys only. Boys only. Committee should be boys only. There is no girl. Okay, boys only means it will come B1, B2, these three groups will come. Okay, why? Because there is no girl here. So in this all there are girls. Okay, so only these comes. So B1, B2, I hope you are understanding. B1, B2, then B1, B3, B1, B3, then B2, B3, B2, B3. Okay, so N of C is equal to N of C, we can write N of C, number of events, N of C we can write it as how much? 3. Okay. So last condition for event D, at the most one girl means maximum one girl should be a member of the committee. Maximum one girl. There is no maximum, minimum it may be anything, but maximum one girl. Minimum, if there is no girl also, it is the committee, but maximum should be one girl. Okay, so we can write D event, we can write there may be no girl also, the maximum one girl. Okay, so maximum one girl, minimum may be anything. Okay, so please understand. So minimum, if there is no girl also, it may come here. So B1, B2, here you may confuse. Okay, at most means maximum one girl, minimum may be anything. Okay, so like that you should remember. B1, B3, then B2, B3, B2, B3, remain this one, you have to leave it, because this is more than one girl. Okay, more than one girl, every concepts will come. So B2, B3 is over, then B1, G1, then B1, G2, then B2, G1, then B2, G2, B2, G2, then next one is the B2, G2 is over, B3, G1, next B3, G2, next, over. So these are the 9, so N of D becomes 9. Okay, I hope you understood the condition and how to apply the condition you knows. Next, last, fourth one we'll discuss. Two dice are rolled, write the sample space and number of sample points N of S. Also write the events and the number of sample points in the event according to the given condition. So here there is a sample it takes lot of time, that's why I have written the sample space. So sample space, when two dice are thrown, already I told, okay, two die are thrown, Already I told sample space how it will come. 1, 1, 1, 2, 1, 3, up to 1, 6 it will come. Then 2, 1, 2, 2, 2, 3, like that 2, 6 it will come. Then 3, 1, 3, 2, 3, 4, 3, 6, like that. Total n of s is how much? It will come n of s, that is nothing but elements of samples point or number of sample point is equal to n of s is equal to 36 will come. Okay, so this is the constant when two dies are thrown. So condition we have to see. Condition: sum of the digits on upper face is a prime number. This is very important. Sum of the digits on upper face is a prime number. So 1 plus 1, it is a 2. 2 is a prime number. Okay, so we can write, this is the event A we will take. When we add these two numbers, it should be prime number. Prime number means 2. 2 is the prime number. Similarly, 3 is a prime number. 5 is a prime number. 7, 11, like this. These are the prime numbers. Okay. So prime numbers means which cannot be divisible by any other numbers. Okay. So if you add these numbers, it should become prime number. Okay, so the numbers are 1 plus 1, that is the 2 it will come, 1, 1, then you can write this 1, 1, then 1, 3, 1, 2, because 3 will come, 1, 4, 3 is not possible, 1, 4, 5 will possible, 1, 4, then 1, 5, 1, 5 is not possible, 1, 6, okay, 7 is possible, 1, 6, next 2, 1, that is 3, 2, 1, okay. Next 2, 2 is not possible, 2, 3, 5, okay, 2, 3, 5, then 2, 4 is not possible, then 2, 5, 7, okay, 2, 5, 7, then next 2, 6, 8 is possible, 3, 1, 4, 3, 2, 5, 3, 2, 5, okay, so like that, all numbers you can write yourself, it takes lot of time because video, it takes consumption. Okay, so A is equal to n of A, we can write n of A will come 15 numbers, okay, 1, 5, 15 numbers will come. So you should remember n of A, like this numbers, how much it will come? 15 numbers, okay. So you can select any numbers from this. So from this 36 numbers, 15 numbers are there, those if you add the numbers, you will get the prime number, okay. Next, second one, sum of the digits on the upper face is a multiple of 5. Multiple of 5 means if you add these numbers, it should be get multiples of 5. For example, see here, 1, 4, 5. So this is the multiple of 5, we can write 1, 4. Okay, I hope you are understanding. We can consider B is the event here. B is the event, we will consider B event. And 1, 4. So 1, comma 4 is the what? Multiple of 5. 5, 1 is not multiple of 5. 6, 1, 2, 1, 2, 2, 2, 3. 2, 3 is the multiple of 5. Okay, 2, 3 is the multiple of 5. Similarly, 2, 4, 6 is not possible. This is also not possible. This is also not possible. 3, 1, 3, 2. 3, 2 is also multiple of 5. 3, 2. Okay. Next, 3, 3 is not possible, 3, 4, 7 is not possible, 3, 5, 8 is not possible, 6, 3 is not possible, 4, 1, that is 5, okay, 4, 1 is possible. Similarly, 4, 1 is possible, 4, 2 is not possible, 4, 3, 7, 4, 4, 8, 4, 5, 9, 4, 6 is possible, okay, 4, 6, 6, 4 is possible, okay, 6, 4 is possible. Similarly, 4, 1, 1, 4 is possible, again, anyone? So 1, 2, 3 and 3, okay, so 6, 6, 4 and 5, 5 is possible, 5, 5 is possible, okay. I hope you understood, this is the problem, so 5, 5 is possible. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 7 is possible, so n of b is equal to 7. I hope you understood, okay. Next, sum of the digits on the upper face is 25. Means if you add these numbers, you should get the 25. So 6 and 6 is the maximum. 12 you will get. Maximum 12 you will get. You cannot get the 25. That's why we can consider this one is the C. sample space or event, C event we will consider as the blank event, that is nothing but null, null set it is, that is denoted as pi, and C is equal to, or n of C is equal to, there is no numbers here, that's why we will consider as zero numbers, okay, zero numbers, and this is known as the null set, okay, null set, because there is no any elements, that's why it's known as the null set, and it is denoted as pi. Next, digit on the upper face of the first die is less than the digit on the second die, means you have to select a number which is less than the second number, okay, so this is the less than second number, no, this is less than the second number, yes, 1, 2, this is the less than second number, yes, 1, 3, 1, 4, 1, 5, okay, so those are the less than the second number, then 1, 6, similarly 2, 2 is not 2, 2 is not there, we can consider 2, 3, because 2, 3 is less than that number, 2, 4, 2, 5, that's also come, 2, 5, 2, 6 also come, okay, I hope you are understanding. Then 3, 1 is not possible, 3, 2 is not possible, 3, 3 is not possible, 3, 4, 3, 4, then 3, 5, 3, 6, okay, I hope you are understanding. Then 4, 1 is not possible, up to 4, 1, 4, 4 is not possible, 4, 5 is possible, then 4, 6 is possible, 5, up to 5, 5 is not possible, 5, 6 is possible, okay, so remaining is only this much. So how much it is, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, so n of D is equal to how much, 15. I hope you understood the concept, okay. So next concept we will discuss, the practice set 5.3. So we will discuss the 5.3 practice set. So first problem we will discuss, write a sample space S and number of sample point n of S for each of the following experiments. Also write the events A, B, C in the set form and write n of A, n of B and n of C. So you have to write those n of A, n of B and n of C. So here there is a concept, so you should write. So write the sample space n and number of sample points. So here they are given, one die is rolled. So one die is rolled means whenever there is a die, so already I told, when there is a only one die is there, then you have to consider sample space as 6, 1 to 6. So therefore sample space we can write 1 to 6. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. Okay. And n of S is how much? Already they told to find the sample point also. Sample point, number of sample point, that is n of S is equal to how much? 1 to 6. That is nothing but 6. So now you have to apply the condition here, event A. So you will write event A as even number on the upper face, even number on the upper face. So which are the even numbers here? 2, 4 and 6, those are the even numbers. So 2, 4 and 6, those are the even numbers. So n of A is how much? I hope you are understanding, n of A is 3. Next, odd number on the upper face. So we will write here odd numbers on the upper face, B is equal to, we will consider event is B, so upper face odd numbers, which are the odd numbers? 1 is the odd number, 3 is the odd number, 5 is the odd number. So 1, 3, 5, so n of B we can write as number of elements here, number of points or number of elements, there are 3. Next, prime number on the upper face. So prime number on the upper face set, you have to write prime number on the upper face, we can write it as prime number. Which are the prime numbers here? 2 is the prime number, 3 is the prime number and 5 is the prime number. Why? Because these numbers are not divisible by any other numbers. So we can write 2, 3, 5. Okay. So n of C is equal to how much? 3. Okay. I hope you understood the concept. Next problem we will discuss. Two dies are rolled simultaneously. We have to write the sample space here. Already I told sample space for two dies are 36. N of S is equal to 36. So in solve example already we discussed. Okay. So sample space, how to write sample space for one die, it is one number will come. Second die when we throw, one number will come. Similarly, first die it may come one and second die may come two. Like that, possibilities are how much? Possibilities are 36 possibilities are there. Okay, so that is the sample space when we throw the two dies. When we throw the two dies, single die is there. If you throw a single die, then what the this one will come? The dice, when we throw the single dice, what the yes sample space will come? 1 2 3 4 5 6. Okay, these are the sample space. When we throw the two dice at a time, then there are 36 sample space will come. These are the sample space. Okay, next we should understood the condition. Now the sum of the digits on the upper faces is a multiple of 6. So you have to check the numbers which is a multiple of 6. So addition, sum, they told sum of the digits. Sum means addition of the digits on the upper faces is a multiple of 6. Multiple of 6 you have to check. So 1 plus 1, 2. Which is a multiple of 6? No. Multiple means table. In 6 table it should come. Okay, when we add two numbers, these numbers, it should be the multiples of 6. Means it should be come in the table of 6. So 3 plus 1, 4 it will come. It is not a multiple. Similarly, 1 plus 5 it will come. Okay, so event A will write 1 comma 5. Because 1 plus 5 if you add will come, answer will come 6. And which is the multiple of 6. Similarly, 2, 3, 2, 4 will come. Okay, 2, 4. 2, 4, 4, 2. Both will come. Okay. Similarly here 5 1 5 5 1 both will come. Okay, so 2 6 will not come. 3 3 will come. Okay, 3 3 you have to, because 3 3 is the 6 multiple of 6 will come. 3 4 will not come. 3 6 9 will not come. 4 2 already I written. 4 3 4 4 8 4 5 4 6 will not come. Then 5 5 10 5 6 no. 6 6 will come, because 5 1 already I written. 5 1 and 1 5 already I written. Then 6 6, last one is the 6 6 will come, because 6 6 is 12, so which is also come. 1 2 3 4 5 6. Okay, so n of second one, n of A is equal to how much? So n of A is equal to, therefore n of A is equal to 6. Okay, I hope you understood. This is the event A and sample points of event A is 6. So next we will discuss the sum of the digits on the upper face is minimum 10. Minimum 10. Sum of the digits. When we add two numbers here, the answer should be less than 10. Okay, so it may come B event, it's maximum, more numbers will come. Okay, so more numbers will come. That is the sum of the digits on the upper face is a minimum 10. So it should be minimum 10. Minimum 10 means which one? The sum of the digits upper faces is minimum 10. So minimum 10 means it should come 1, 1. This is the 1. 1, 2 also come. 1, 3 also come. 1, 4 also come. Then 1, 5 also come, because which is minimum 10. Then 1, 6 also come. Okay, minimum 10 they ask. So minimum 10 or maximum 10? Minimum 10 only they ask. So 1, 6, then 2, 1 will come. 2, 2 will come. You can convert this one as the, okay, so 2, 2, then 2, 3 will come. 2, 4 will come. Okay, minimum, when we add this one, you should come minimum than 10. So we can select here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I will write directly here only, because it takes lot of time. 5, 6, 7, then 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, then 18, then 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 23, this is not coming because it is 6 plus 4, it will come 10, minimum 10 we required. Okay, so 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, this is not present, 28, this is also not present, 29, 30. Okay, so maximum it will come, you can write yourself. Okay, so dash dash I will write, you can write yourself. So how many numbers will come? That is the n of b is equal to 30 numbers will come. Those 30 I shown here. Okay, so those 30 you have to write here. That is the answer. Next, event C, the same digit on both the upper faces. Same digit on both the upper faces. So same digit 11, then 22, then similarly 33, like that. How many digits will come? That is the same numbers it should come. So event C is equal to 11, then same number. So 11 is the same number, similarly 22 is also same number, 33 is also same number, 44, then 55, then 66. Okay, so these are the numbers you will get. See here, the same digit on the both the upper faces. So both the upper faces means when we thrown the two dice, there is a upper face will come. So you have to check those numbers should be same. So n of c is equal to how much? 6. Okay, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, I hope you understood the concept. So 3 coins are tossed simultaneously. 3 coins are tossed simultaneously. We should write the sample space first. Okay, so 3 coins are tossed simultaneously. Sample space will come. S is equal to 3 coins are tossed simultaneously. Sample space is HHH. Already I told 8 sample space will come, that is the 8 number sample space will come. HHT, okay, then HTH, HTH, then THH, THH, then HTT, HTT, then HTHT, then TTH, TTH, then TTT. Okay, so these are the sample space. See here, how to write the sample space. First, you have to write the 3 heads, then 1 tail will come, last 1 tail will come, then next again 2 heads, 1 tail, middle tail will come, this tail will goes here and head will come. Similarly, again this tail, it will come here, that is the tail and 2 heads. Okay, I hope you are understanding, this is over. Next, 2 tails will come and 1 head will come. Again this head will transfer here, that is the middle tail head will come. Again the head will transfer here from here to last. Okay, like this you have to remember. Total n of s is how much? N of s is equal to 8. Okay, so these are the sample space when 3 coins are tossed simultaneously, means similarly you have to toss 3 coins. Okay, so see here, condition they are given. A condition, that is the A event is there to get at least 2 heads. At least means minimum, minimum 2 heads. Maximum may be anything, minimum 2 heads. Okay, minimum 2 heads should be present. Minimum 2 heads, maximum may be anything. 2 heads means see here, this is the 3 heads also may be come here. Minimum 2 heads should be present. Okay, so 3 heads may come. So head may come. This is the first one. 2 heads, head tail, that is also present. Head tail head, that is also present. Tail head, that is also present. Okay, so here there is a only 1 head is there, but you required how much? Minimum 2 heads we require. So that's why only this much it will come, that is the 4. So n of a is equal to how much? N of a is equal to 4. I hope you understood. Minimum 2 heads. At least 2 heads means minimum 2 heads may be present. It may 4 heads may present, 3 heads may present, 5 heads may present, but minimum 2 heads may be present. Okay. So next B event is what? Event B, to get no head. No head means there should be no head. So here also there is a head, 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 here also there is a head. No head means only one condition is there, that is TTT. There is no head here. So therefore N of B is equal to how much? Only 1. I hope you are understanding. Last one is condition for C, that is C event is equal to what? To get head on the second coin. Head on the second coin. Second coin means here this is the first coin, this is the second coin, middle is the second coin, and third one is the this coin. Okay. So they given the condition is what? To get head on the second coin means middle. Middle, where is the head? That you have to take. So head, head, head. So this is the middle is the head. Okay. Then this is also middle, head is there, head, head, tail. Then here there is no middle head here, leave it. So this is the head. Okay. So there is no middle head. So here there is a middle head. So T head, head. Then here there is no middle head. Here there is a middle head. T head, head. Second they told. Okay. Second coin means middle. Head, there is no middle head. Here there is also no middle head. So therefore N of C is equal to how much? N of C is 4. Okay. I hope you understood. These are the condition for a given third problem. Okay. Next we will discuss. Okay. Third, fourth, fifth, sixth. We'll discuss later.